Now it's the people who make a church, and people influence other people. We've heard the tiniest Sunday school junior choir, and we heard the senior choir, and we've heard the in-betweens. These are the people who make up a church. And generations come and generations go, but the Word of God lives on forever. The song that we are going to sing to you is a song that was taught to me by a Sunday school teacher years ago in Bangalore. Now, the interesting thing about this Sunday school teacher is she's the grand-aunt of our choir master, Kurian. Now, I never thought that I would get to sing in the same choir as my Sunday school teacher's grand-nephew. She taught us this song one morning on a Sunday when we came to church, all of us children. She said, "I'm much older than you, and I've gone through much more in life than any of you have. Some of you might have gone through some storms in life, but a large number of you don't even know what a storm in life means." And most of us looked at her puzzled. What does she mean by storms in life? It definitely can't be the thunder and lightning that we see occasionally when the rain falls. Must be more than that. She said, "You may not understand what it means now, and the song may not make much of an impression on you today. But let me tell you, boys and girls, one day, when you do go through storms in life, and all believers do that, they do go through storms in life, this song will make a deep impression on you. So learn the song, take the words to heart, keep it somewhere stored up inside you, so that one day when you need it, it will come out and it will be a song that will bless you and bless those around you." And the English Wing is proud to present this song in memory of that Sunday school teacher who was part of a congregation that made a lasting impression. We are singing the song for Mrs. Akama Jacob, and the song is based on the wonderful miracle found in Mark chapter 4. Where it says, "On that day, when evening had come, Jesus said to them, 'Let us go across to the other side.' And leaving the crowd, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was, and other boats were with him. And a great storm of wind arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion, and they woke him and said to him, 'Teacher, do you not care if we perish?' And he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, 'Peace, be still.' And the wind ceased and there was a great calm. He said to them, 'Why are you afraid? Have you no faith?' And they were filled with awe and said to one another, 'Who then is this that even wind and sea obey him?'"